Welcome back to our channel. In this video, we bring you the ultimate guide to the best places to live in Oregon. Whether you are a nature lover, a city enthusiast, or looking for a perfect mix of both, Oregon has something for everyone. In this video, we'll explore the diverse landscapes, vibrant communities, and unique characteristics of different cities and regions in Oregon. Let's dive in. Oregon has a lot going for it, including beautiful Pacific shorelines, towering mountains, breathtaking sunsets, miles upon miles of trails ideal for hiking and bicycling, and clear, clean water sources like lakes and rivers. The state of Oregon offers a wide variety of desirable places to call home, from the bustling metropolis to the quaint villages, from the high desert regions in the east rich of hot springs and animals to the lush forested sections along the coast. The ideal place to live is subjective, depending on the person and their criteria. While some people long for the peace and quiet of a rural setting, others want for the excitement and variety of urban life. The high desert of Oregon, which boasts an average of 300 sunny days per year, may be an attractive option for some, while others may prefer an ocean view. However, while looking for a new area to call home, there are a few factors that many people prefer to compare, including cost of living, population, quality of educational institutions, and surrounding activities to do. Number 1. Hillsboro. Hillsboro is about 20 miles west of Portland, making it convenient for commutes into the city when necessary. Regardless, this is one of the best places to live in Oregon because of the abundance of jobs, services, and green spaces available here. Prior to the arrival of computer giants like Intel and Oracle in the late 1980s, Hillsboro was a relatively unremarkable small town. It has since blossomed into a hub for the biomedical, telecommunications, banking, and data center industries. The area between Hillsboro and Beaverton is so well known for its tech industry that it is often called the Silicon Forest. Hillsboro is one of the top Oregon cities for finding work and advancing in one's career, with a median household income of over $92,000. Number 2. Bend. I anticipate criticism from some residents on my classification of Bend as a large city, but with a population that's getting close to 100,000, it certainly qualifies. And I'll give credit where credit is due, Bend is a wonderful, picturesque city. Now that I've gotten that off my chest, I'll explain why I think Bend is Central Oregon's best spot to settle down. To begin, this is the kind of place everyone wishes they could call home. There's always something exciting going on in Bend, and the city is most known for two things: its excellent outdoor activities and its many excellent breweries. Bend is, in the opinion of many Oregonians, including myself, one of the state's premier urban areas for outdoor enthusiasts. Your backyard is surrounded by natural beauty, you need not go far to enjoy it. There are countless hiking options, from scenic ponderosa pine groves to towering peaks in the Cascade Range. Don't take my word for it, everyone loves this city in Oregon. In 2020, WalletHub predicted that Bend would be the second fastest expanding major city in the United States. As one of Oregon's top retirement destinations, Bend attracts a diverse population. However, now that the secret is out, you can expect to mingle with people from all walks of life. Number 3. Sherwood. Sherwood is a charming small city that is conveniently located between Portland, just 35 minutes away, and Newburgh, with its many vineyards, and Wilsonville, only 16 minutes away. Numerous restaurants, bars, and entertainment venues can be found in the area. There are many wineries in the area, as well as the Tualatin River National Wildlife Refuge, Langer's Entertainment Center, Sleighbells Gift Shop, a year-round Christmas store is always a good idea, and the Sherwood Ice Arena. This village in the Willamette Valley has a low crime rate and wonderful park and outdoor space access. Over half, 51% of Sherwood's adult population holds a bachelor's degree or more, and 97% of residents aged 25 and up have at least a high school diploma. With roughly 1,684 pupils, Sherwood High School has been given a rating of 9 out of 10. Number 4. West Lynn. West Lynn, also called the City of Hills, Trees, and Rivers, is a tiny town in Oregon with a low crime rate. Outdoor activities are plenty here, but if you need to stock up on clothes, you need only drive 30 minutes to Portland. Guests can visit the Oregon City Golf Club, Canema Bluff Nature Park, Mary South Young Park, Camassia Nature Preserve, and nearby vineyards, as well as the nearby Newell Creek Canyon Nature Park and Camassia Nature Preserve. A total of 27,103 individuals call West Lynn home, with whites making up 86% of the population. Among the adult population in West Lynn, 97% have completed high school or above, and 62% have earned a four-year college degree or higher. With roughly 1,860 pupils, West Lynn High School has been given a 9/10 grade. Number 5. Medford. Medford is one of Oregon's most beautiful cities due to its setting in the state's undulating hills. In all honesty, it's not hard to understand why. Medford, located near the California border and less than 80 miles from the coast, is a haven for individuals who aren't afraid of being self-sufficient. There are many farms in the area and provides an easy standard of living. This city in Oregon has its own airport, Rogue Valley International Airport, so you'll never have to feel too far away. There will very certainly be layovers, but hey, it beats driving the 3 hours to the nearest airport. In the summer, when Ashland hosts the world-famous Oregon Shakespeare Festival, Medford appears to be at its liveliest. In the summertime, the area is also flooded with Oregonians on the lookout for a relaxing weekend at some of the state's most beautiful wineries. Number 6. Wilsonville. Wilsonville is situated on the northern bank of the Willamette River, providing convenient access for those who own boats or like kayaking on the river. Wilsonville, which has a low crime rate, is home to many people who commute to Portland for employment. Bullwinkle's Fun Center, Memorial Park, several vineyards, and Coal Creek Golf Course are all within easy driving distance. Number 7. Lincoln City. It would be foolish not to include a coastal town on any list of the greatest places to live in Oregon. Even though it rains and is cloudy in Lincoln City for the most of the year, I still think it's a great place to call home. This well-liked metropolis of Oregon's central coast boasts unparalleled natural beauty. The area has some of the best beaches in the state, including my personal favorite recreation area, Devil's Lake. These retirees who may sit for hours observing the mighty Pacific Ocean are the town's primary demographic. With a median age of 50, it's clear that many Lincoln City residents view the coast as a desirable retirement destination. Most people tend to be unhappy with the few options they have for receiving medical care in their area. Number 8. Scappoose. Scappoose, Oregon, has the small-town atmosphere you've been looking for. It is in the county of the same name and the northwest corner of the state. In reality, Portland can be reached in just half an hour by car. Scappoose, on the other hand, has only 7,100 residents yet nevertheless manages to maintain a Mayberry vibe. Excellent for starting or growing a family. Scappoose boasts a low crime rate and frequent local events that bring the community together. The median value of a home is $273,800, and the average household earns $79,400 per year. Scappoose also offers plenty of entertainment options. The Scappoose Bay River Trail is a popular destination for weekend treks for many locals. It's also a pleasant area for bicycling and strolling. The town's proximity to the Columbia River means that many locals spend their weekends pitching tents along its peaceful banks. Number 9. Tualatin. Tualatin, Oregon, United States, is a lovely city located in the scenic Tualatin Valley. With a population of around 30,000, Tualatin strikes the ideal balance between quaint small-town living and progressive conveniences. The city's stunning features include the peaceful Tualatin River, which flows through the center of town. There are several parks and natural places for those who want to get in touch with nature by walking, riding bikes, or looking for animals. The historic district of Tualatin is alive with local stores, eateries, and enterprises that welcome both locals and tourists. The city is known for its strong sense of community, which is fostered by the many annual events and festivals it hosts. Tualatin has a lot to offer in terms of quality of life because of its attractive setting, plenty of recreational possibilities, and strong sense of community. Number 10. Milwaukee. Milwaukee, Oregon, is another fantastic place to call home. It's a suburb of Portland that spans both Clackamas and Multnomah counties. You're in the best part of Oregon if you're close to Portland. Milwaukee is located along the scenic Willamette River and is sometimes referred to as the Dogwood City of the West. The crime rate there is similarly low to that of the other two suburbs we mentioned. The whole family will love this. The town's 21,000 residents are drawn there by the low cost of living and plentiful job opportunities. In reality, a family of four in Milwaukee can expect to have a median annual income of $63,000. The jobless rate is 4.5% as well. The community is a nice medium-class neighborhood, not as hosh-posh as West Lynn or Lake Oswego. In Milwaukee, the median value of a home is $291,000. The convenience of being able to ride a bike wherever is another perk of living in Milwaukee. In this wonderful community, many of the residents ride bicycles to work every day. You'd be saving a lot on petrol money and getting regular exercise. The town's diverse sights and rich history will keep you and your loved ones busy for days. Thank you for joining us on this journey, and we hope this guide has been helpful in your quest to find the best place to live in Oregon. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more travel guides and helpful information. Until next time, happy exploring!